Hi all, this is Ilish, and I'm reviewing a game against Mickael in the Spicee Tour. I go first, and on the board we have three powerful cards, which actually form a combo as well. So we have three red to three green, three green to three brown, and three yellow to three red. Apart from that, the triple upgrader is also nice. And so I proceed to take the red to green, as it combos with either one of the other two. Then Mickael takes the green to brown, which makes sense because he's sure that I will take the yellow to red. Then this way he doesn't have to give up a yellow for it. And then he takes the triple upgrader. So at this point I have two cards that work well with each other, but I will still need yellow producer to use this to its full effect, and there's nothing on the board yet in that department. I have actually a green input card. It's the green rainbow card, as I like to call it, because it produces all three of the other colors, but I don't like it that much. I will get into that later, but also I noticed that there's the two brown to three green, one red, one yellow, which combos very well with what Mickael already has. So the way I look at the board now is that I already have an advantage because of these two cards. And now it's time to protect that advantage and take away a potential combo from Mickael. So I'm taking the brown input card. Okay, so for Mickael, the green input card is useless. He already has one green input card, which is better. So he takes a good quality production card. So now I can take the green input card and take back two of the yellows. And the next he takes red to brown. So the point is he now has two cards with brown output. And in the meantime, the incoming cards include another brown input card, which would be very useful for Mickael, and a mass yellow producer, which would be very useful to me. So in this position, I'm looking at taking either of those two cards, but I don't like giving up too many yellows just yet. So instead, I make two yellows, and Mickael also goes on to produce some reds this time. So he didn't take the brown input card, probably because he thought that if he takes it, I can take the mass yellow producer for just two additional yellows, and then I would be able to take back some of those. And he didn't like those options. But now, so this game could go in many different directions. If Mickael takes the brown input card, then I take the mass yellow producer, and then we're off. But if I deny him the next brown input card, then his hand will be very crippled. It might cost me the mass yellow producer, but I feel like my hand will still be better. So I take it from him. So at this point, he has two cards that produce a lot of browns, but no way to come down from those browns, so he will actually have to spend them. Now, this is doable on this board with a lot of brown-heavy cards. And now Mickael takes another production card, so here I'm facing a choice. I can take the quality mass yellow producer right now, but it will cost me a lot of tempo, because I will have to give up another yellow. And I don't really like that option. I feel like my hand is better and I might be able to get away without the quality yellow producer. There is actually another yellow producer card following it, so eventually I might look to take that one. But for now, I just take back the yellows with the idea that... okay. So he does deny me the quality mass yellow producer. So from this position, I can reset to 6 yellows with 2 more moves. And then I can start up to reds and greens. And the point cards. So the point cards are such that a smaller value point card is followed by 3 very expensive ones. And in this position, I look to take the first one mostly because it's cheaper and it will leave me with more cubes to work with after. Also for Mickael, with no way down from brown, he will actually have to spend those browns that he makes. So for him, the expensive cards are a good choice. But still, I feel like it is more important to be able to continue for me, and I'm not worried about offering some of the expensive cards to Mickael. Okay, so at this point, I'm still looking to take this card eventually, but first I want to assemble the cost for the 12-point card at the 3-coin slot before Mickael does. And Mickael's game plan at this point is probably to use the production cards a lot. He also has the triple upgrader, and he has a 3 red to 2 brown trade card, which is very useful with the production cards because he will be able to produce a lot of reds. So overall, his game plan is probably to produce a lot of reds and upgrade them to brown. And apart from that, use the production card and the triple upgrader. It's very versatile, and it's not to be underestimated, despite an ability to come back down from brown, because he can make a lot of reasonably good moves. He will have a very even progress as the game goes on. Okay, so I'm looking to reset to 6 yellows, and actually 9 yellows would be better, but I have no way to rapidly reset to that. And also, once I arrive at 6 greens, I look to use the green rainbow card to give me the cost for the 12-point card. And from more greens, let's say 9 greens or anywhere between 8 to 10, using this card will result in some waste, as using it multiple times involves discarding a lot of yellows. So I'm fine with going for 6 greens for now. Okay, meanwhile, Mickael is producing a lot of reds to go up to browns. And he takes one more production card, which makes sense to him because production cards are basically what he will play most of the time. And if he has more, then he can prolong his pickup loop, play more cards before having to pick up. The green also gives him some added versatility. In the meantime, I assemble the cost for the 12-point card. Now, I'm still looking to take this card, but I wanted to assemble the 12-point first. And the thing with leaving trade cards on the board for some time is that I give the option to the opponent to take them, but this card is useless for him as he has no way to efficiently go up from yellows. So if he takes it, it will cost him tempo. So I'm happy either way. Okay, but now I have the 12-point card assembled, and he still didn't put together the cost for it. So now I can take the yellow producer. And once he also assembles the cost for the 12-point card, I take it from him. And of course, he has to spend the browns, and he has just been given a chance to spend many of those browns, but I will have to live with this. And so the thing about the green rainbow card and all the other cards that give a lot of different colors is that they are very versatile in the sense that they can give a lot of different colors. So they help putting together the cost of three or four color point cards easily. But they also leave my hand fragmented in the sense that I don't have a lot of any single color cube. And that's an issue because most of the trade cards take a single color as an input. So if I want to use them multiple times, then I will need a lot of cubes of a single color. So my hand is too fragmented for that. And usually the way to fix it is with the upgrade card, and I will do that. But also there are a few trade cards that take two colors as input, and I actually have one of them. So from red and yellow, I can go to brown. And together with the upgrade card, this allows me to rapidly reset to four browns, which is useful because I have taken the two brown input cards early on for denial. So I can use one of those after resetting to four browns. Okay, Mickael takes one more production card before picking up. And now I can use, and I actually prefer to reset to reds and greens, basically because after that I will be able to reset to 10 greens. And from 10 greens, I can use the green rainbow card to give me a lot of browns and also some reds. So at this point, my plan is to go after whichever card is at the 3-coin slot, so it will be the 18, but I could go after the 20 as well, using the green rainbow card 5 times. So after taking the 18, yes, and using the green rainbow card from 10 greens means that I do have to discard a lot of yellows, so this wasn't a very efficient step. It didn't give me any power at all, but I'm hoping that the moves before it, so notably going down from four browns and then resetting to greens, are powerful enough that altogether I should still be ahead. So now I can take the 18-point card. And I have reset to four reds. And now I can start using the yellow producer card and just chain together some efficient moves. Meanwhile, Mickael takes the 12-point card, which is a bit of a surprise. I expected him to go after the 20. He probably thinks he has time to still take the 20 before I do. Let's see what happens. So now my plan is to reset to greens, 8 greens notably, and then I will be able to use the green rainbow card again. Meanwhile, Mickael is just producing more reds and yellows. Then probably he will upgrade some yellows to reds. But I am one move away from being able to assemble the 20-point card. So I will be able to take it before he does. Now, again, from a nearly full stack of cubes, using the green rainbow card results in a lot of waste. But I'm not worried anymore because now I can take the 20-point card and I still have four reds to restart. Meanwhile, Mickael does basically the only powerful move he can make. So apart from all the production cards, he can go from red to brown, and he does it to its full potential, so three times. But at this point, I'm taking the 20 point before him. Now, there are actually a number of brown point cards coming in, so he could go after the 11 point here or the 17. So eventually, he should be able to spend all of those browns. Meanwhile, I can run my combo again. By this point, I'm ahead on tempo. Also, I have three of the 3 coins. So I don't have to worry about the end game anymore. I just need to proceed efficiently and then spend all my cubes. Okay, so he takes the 11. And again, I have an easy target. The 13 point card should be good because I will still have four reds to restart after that. And meanwhile, Mickael is setting up the cost for the 18 point card. But now I'm at 4 point cards, so this is the end game. And I'm just looking to finish efficiently, and one way to do that is to go after the 12 point card here, which would leave me with three reds, and I can upgrade those to greens and add two yellows to take the 11. The step order is just that I assemble the cost for both before buying either, so Mickael cannot interfere. And I'm not worried about what he is doing at this point. So even if I don't close him out, I should be ahead. And he manages to put together the cost for the 17. So this is not a hard close out, but still the fact that I was able to put together some powerful moves involving the yellow to red and the red to green gave me enough tempo so that I win. Okay, so the main points in this game were starting with an early advantage, basically from a lucky initial board, and then protecting that advantage by playing very heavy denial. Of course, I will get denied in return from the best yellow producer card, but I had enough to run an efficient combo anyway, while his hand was mostly crippled, and he had to resort to using a lot of production cards with the occasional powerful move chained in. And another thing was that he left the third three coin on the board, which I think was a minor mistake, but that wasn't really what cost him the game. It only made the difference slightly larger. Okay, so that's it. I hope you liked it. Till next time.